So yesterday you would have seen us giving the rear bar a fair bit of a going, but we're down to the last two bolts today, and we've got the heat gun out, we've got the WD-40, we've been whacking it with a hammer on this side just to try and free it up, and it's not really playing the game at the moment. Gonna give it one last chance, and then the old grinder might have to come out, I think. Might be a bit of a hack job, so just down to these last two. Once we get these out, as far as we're aware, these are the last two, then it might just be a matter of sliding it off. Doesn't always go like that, so we'll see how it goes. But yeah, chip away at it, I reckon. Yeah, it is, so I've got to hold it back this way.
Coming out.
My goodness. Look at it.
Yeah.
Holy schnitzel. That's a bit of an effort. Wow-wee. Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's a swelter of a day up here in the Northern Rivers. Sun's beaming. We've got the old Cobra out, long sleeve shirt. Ready to go, sweating up a storm. This thing is a permission. But yeah, it might look like a pretty quick job, and we're just gonna, you know, pump it out in probably about 2 minutes of film time for you guys. But this is actually the second day that we're onto this. That's what happens when you get corroded nuts and bolts that have been on there for probably 20 years and a hell of a lot of abuse. So yeah, loving it. So the idea that we've come up with is we're die grinding the middle of the head of the bolt out in the hope that it's just going to thin it out and make it a bit weaker, so we're going to be able to snap it off and just punch it through, and hopefully that'll do us. But yeah, see how we go.
Hey guys, thought I'd make an appearance. We have been dumped with so much rain, so it's been a few days since we last caught up with you. Would have last seen it, we were getting the rear bar off. I've been busy behind the camera, so I have been here, but yeah, I've been behind the camera. So today I thought I'd just jump on and let you know what we're up to next. Michael's actually working up the front to get that driver's side guard off again. I know, why are we getting it off again after we put the car back together? But we've actually been sent a new snorkel and airbox from Moonlight Performance. So we are going to be taking the guard off because we need a new one. We currently have a safari snorkel on there, so you know, the holes aren't going to match up. We needed to get a whole new guard. So yeah, I'm going to go around to Michael. He's going to explain a bit more to you, but that's just sort of why we're getting it off. And let's go around and see Michael to see what he's up to at the moment.
Okay, so around the front with me, guys, we've unbolted the guard. We've taken the bolts out of the headlight and we've unscrewed the grill, so it's just a matter of all pulling it off. We're going to try and get this. The bull bar is actually jammed, wedged up against this, so it's a bit of a task to get it off, but we're going to get that off. And that's also another thing I'm going to touch base on, is the bull bar is going to get replaced because that's all mangled and it makes it very hard for this to come off, and it's all wedged, so we're going to fix that. New snorkel, new airbox, it's all getting done. So yeah, let's rip into it.
Radio guys, so we have the guard off.
I repeat.
Do you like our new microphones? Thanks, DJI mics. These, hopefully you can notice our sound quality is better. Anyway, I'm going to pass this over to Michael and he's going to tell you what's going on here.
We have the airbox here. And you know when you look at something on your car and it's just like not right? Like it's just going to be a problem? Well, this is going to be a problem. We're going to show you up nice and close. But this thing looks like we're going to go under a water crossing.
and the car's not going to start. It just looks, it's scary. So I'm going to take a guess and say this is a stock airbox. I'm pretty sure it is. Correct me if I'm wrong, but this thing's probably been on here for 30 years. And yeah, there's... Yeah, around where the piping goes for your snorkel. It's like, we'll show you nice and close. But we're going to replace this big dog, put a freshie in there. We'll be all sweet to go. So we've just taken the first pipe off and we're onto the second little elbow piece, and the freaking screw is rounded off to the absolute shitter. I mean, it feels loose anyway, so I don't know, it's probably not meant to be like that. But keep in mind, this was not my car. So you're all probably wondering what's in here. Well, it's a new airbox from Moonlight, so we're going to get it unpackaged and show you guys what it's all about. Like a 5-year-old on Christmas Day. Okay, now get a look at how much better and more durable that looks already. What we're going to do is we're going to take it apart and actually show you guys why we've decided to go with it. And the seal, one thing, this thing's not bent like our old one, so that's definitely a positive. No dust or water's getting in here just by looking at it already, so let's get cracking. So guys, what you've got is you've got 3 wing nuts that hold this side in, and then it's sort of sitting under 3 clamps on the other side, you could say, and it's definitely held in a lot tighter than your stock airboxes. So with your airbox comes with an air filter. You obviously have to take the plastic off that, so we'll take the plastic off that, fit that back in there, get this all screwed back on, and then we'll get to fitting it.
Rightio, so we just ended up getting the rubbers to fit through the mounting bracket. It was a little bit tricky, but now I'm just mounting that bracket back on the inner guard under here, ready to mount the airbox to, so it's all very exciting.
As we've mentioned before, we are replacing the bull bar. So the next step in order to finish off this whole snorkel airbox system is to remove this. So then we can put the new guard on there, fit it all up, mark the hole out where the snorkel's gonna go, cut it, take it off, respray it without the bull bar being in the way and marking up our fresh new panel. So yeah, we're gonna have a bit of fun getting this thing off. Stick along for the ride. The bolts are gonna be a bit, how you going? If I'm judging off the rear bar.
And we've been spraying them for weeks.
We've been spraying them with WD-40 for weeks, so hopefully that's going to work in our favour. But,
what are those easy as you think?
No, not everything goes to plan, as you would know if you've worked on a four-wheel drive before. So here we are, bar number two, and I've already cracked in the two bolts and I've been successful. So I don't want to get my hopes up too early, but it's looking good so far. So as you would have seen, we've just taken the front mount intercooler out. We had to undo the clamps on the hose to get that undone. So that's out of the way. We've just taken all the wiring off the winch. So that's out of the way. And when we pull it out, nothing's gonna, you know, tangle itself up and get caught. So now it's just a matter of getting to these four bolts and hopefully getting it undone. See how we go. Just be careful. Yeah, I'm right. Yeah. Yeah, I got it. Easy as. And that's why you use a chassis flusher, because that is absolutely disgusting. So now that the bull bar is out of the way, we have plenty of space to work with, and bolting this guard back on, making sure it fits how it should before we go cutting any holes for the snorkel. Howdy folks, it's another day, another hole in my guard. Let's have a bit of fun, eh? Where we've taped up the guard, taken the airbox out like the instructions say, so to fit this snorkel. So now it's all that's left to do is to literally put this exactly where it tells you. I'll show you if the wind doesn't play around. It'll say bolt, hole. You can see there's a bolt and a hole here, corner of the bonnet. And that's what lines it up, has a line that runs through it where the crease does to match that all up. So we're about to put this exactly where it should be, tape it up, and then start marking out the hole that you see. So now that we've got the hole cut, we've taken the tape off and filed the edges. We're just going to put this pinch weld on, because we're going to just have a look and see how this snorkel actually sits. And this is going to just prevent it from scratching the snorkel while it's in pristine condition. So we'll chuck this on and see how she looks. Folks, so welcome back to another day on the 80. It's a swelter of a day, and we've decided we're going to tackle the rear bar. She's looking a bit bare at the moment, so we're going to cover the old girl up. And what are we going to cover her up with? We got the Raslarr new style rear bar going on with the swing away jerry and the swing away tire. So we've got to get stuck right into it. We've got a few holes to drill, get some plates fitted up before we can even whack it on, but let's give this a crack and see how we go, eh? So what I'm doing now, before we have the holes drilled out and we fit the bar on, I'm putting these lights on just because I don't know how much space I'm gonna have. So these lights they give you with the rear bar. It comes with a little bracket that they've welded onto the bar here, and you simply just put the bolt through the hole. Sits there nicely, spring washer, and then your nut. And the wire feeds through a hole that they've put there as well. Okay, so that was a little bit of an effort, but we got her on there. We've just been fiddling around with the lights. We got these all fitted and tightened up to where they should be. We're about to pop rivet the brackets on for the driving and the brake lights, and then away we go. Then we can start looking at the swingaways. They give you a pinch weld as well that can go around the edge of the wings, so just to protect it. But yeah, moving along nicely. Okay, so we've got the guard all prepped, painted up, it's all ready to go back on. So what we're going to do today is we're going to bolt that back on, and what that means is we can fit our snorkel, get all the airbox linked up to the snorkel and get it all functioning and working and how it should look. So let's wait no further and get stuck into it. So we're back in to snorkel work. Now our next step is to insert some riv nuts. So, nutserts. You need a nutsert tool to actually do this. And we're lucky enough to have one. Most people probably aren't lucky enough to have it. Riv nut gun. So we're gonna insert these three riv nuts, and then we're good to bolt up the whole snorkel. Get the pipe on there, and then we're talking about finishing up on the airbox and having it all plumbed up nicely. So let's get stuck into it.
Squeeze the handle, whatever you do.
Don't squeeze it yet.
No. Wait till you get it in there, right in.
Got to get it in.
Yeah.
Like that.
Yeah.
Right. Yep. Now go.
Yep.
Oh.
There it goes. Yeah, that's it.
That's it.
Yep. Is it not moving? Is it moving at all?
It's got the
no. No, it's not moving.
Geez, if that's a steel one, I'd hate to see
it. Your stainless one.
Ooh.
Yeah.
So they give you stainless ones, but we've gone for the steel ones just because we don't have a gun. It's going to, or an air gun. You can have an air gun, or you can have a twin arm one that gives you a bit more leverage. We don't have that, so we've opted for the steel option. It's a bit more easier to put in with these guns. Still a little bit more effort. I'd hate to try a stainless one with this. Jeez. Yeah, I've got one. Yep. I believe that's...
I'm just training you. Just watching you.
Yeah, jeez. I think I've just worn away like 5 mil off my teeth from gritting them together for that. Holy dooly, but it's what you got to do. Okay, so the aim of the game was to sort of...
Yeah. Friction down, it's got to go.
See how we go, we got to get these ones in.
Yep.
I am just putting the bolts into this bracket that's on the inner guard, because you have to get that one fixed first. We'll get that all done up, and then we're going to attach the snorkel to the bracket that's on the pillar.
Okay. So, now we've got two screws. Well, two bolts of the screw in.
So I've managed to just slip the pipe over the snorkel. Now the mission is to try and get the clamp on. Now for any snorkel, this is going to be a hard bit of a mission, because you're fiddling around with, you know, small minute holes, and you're getting your hand all bent and it feels like you're going to break your wrist, but you're not, hopefully. But yeah, you kind of, I've got to try and pull this clamp to be in line with the pipe around the snorkel, so that it's actually going to do up over the piping and the snorkel itself, which is the whole aim of the game. Once we get this one done up, then you're talking airbox going in, putting the clamp on the side of the airbox over this pipe. So we're almost there, guys. This car is not far off running.
Final 9 weeks.
Final 9 weeks. We've got a bit of a countdown. The rush is on. I feel like there's going to be a few sleepless nights maybe before the big trip in the big girl. But it's all going to be worth it. We all build these cars for a reason. It's because it takes us out on these amazing journeys. So I'm more than happy to pour my time and efforts into this beauty of a beast, you could say.
Thank you so much for watching. That brings us to the end of another episode. We hope to see you on the next one, where we get messy with reassembling the rear driveline.